practicing preparing the cake. Continue doing so.
That was the win.
Would you call the cake something involved or fiddly, perhaps? Even if you wore it day in, day out, you would still be that's why both Godinho, who's the vulgar author, and Figueyredo, who's the espresso author, stressed several times in several different sentences, in many different paragraphs, to prepare your cape out of measure. Don't ever prepare your cape in measure, because that gets you dead. I'm sure you can understand why. But if you consider what you're doing with the cape while you're drawing, you are keeping your opponent at bay while you're. It's also worth noting that these are practice capes. They're made out of cotton. They are awesome, and I will not hear a negative word said about them. However, the originals are made out of wool and velvet, so the weight will be different, the drape will be different, and that probably affects how to prepare the cape. But because we're not made of money, that's why you don't have wool cape.
And because of Queensland.
Yeah. All right. If you're ready to go to the dismissal stuff.
Ready?
Yep.
Let's.
Okay. So now you know the vulgar style, where the cape comes completely off of your body.
Put a step first.
There you go. Now we're going to try it the stressa style. You've done it vulgar, now we're going to go to the stressa. You'll probably appreciate it.